That's that money talk. That's that money talk. Got a lot of fans, a lot of haters. We just let them talk. Cause they'll never face us to the paper. What you talking about? The earth will really shake it with this craters that we throwing out, yeah. Came up in the game and gave it mouth to mouth.
What is up, you guys? It's your boy T-Rez back with another video. And we just talked about the Trailblazers and the Nuggets in last video. We just talked about them and who I thought was going to win Game 7. And ultimately, I said it's Dame Dallas time. Baby, it's Dame Dallas time. All right, that's basically what I said in that last video. Go check it out. And right now we are talking about another great series that's also going to Game 7, and it's the 76ers versus the Raptors. And this has been a great series as well. The Raptors took Game 1, the 76ers took Game 2 and Game 3, the Raptors took Game 4 and Game 5, and then the 76ers take Game 6. Alright, so who do I have in Game 7? Who do I have in Game 7? And I think I'm going to pick, my original pick was Toronto. That was my original pick. And it is in Toronto. The final game is in Toronto. So I'm going to have to pick. I'm going to have to pick 76ers. I think the 76ers take this one on the road. I feel it. The 76ers take this one on the road. I'm going against my prediction. Forget that. 76ers take Game 7 on the road. All right? And guess what? Jimmy Butler's been having a great series. So I expect nothing different from this game today. He's been having a great series. So I expect him to continue to have a great series. Ben Simmons has been all right. He's been Ben Simmons, you know, scoring about 10 points a game, 7 assists, 7 rebounds. That's what he's been doing. So maybe more like 6 assists and 6 rebounds. But he's been putting up those kind of numbers. And I think he's not going to do anything different this game. I think what it really comes down to is Joel Embiid and Tobias Harris. When they have pretty good games, they make it easy to win. Now, it's unrealistic to say both of them is going to have a great game. But Joel Embiid, I'm saying he's going to have a great game. I say Jimmy Butler's going to score about 30, and Joel Embiid's going to match him. I say Tobias Harris is going to score about 15. And, J.J. Redick going to help with that with about 10. And it's not that they don't have as much depth as Toronto. They don't. They just don't. But it's just their starting five, their starting five has more power than Toronto's. And that's what's going to come down to, and that's how the 76ers are going to win this game, all right? And then on Toronto's side, they got Kawhi, who's been killing. He's been a monster. And Kyle Lowry has been showing up in games, and he's been disappearing. And so this game, I say he's going to disappear. You know, he's had that effect on Toronto since they've been making the playoffs. Kyle Lowry has not been a playoff guy, and he's just very inconsistent in the playoffs, you know? Very inconsistent. I think it was game three, he scored like 7 points. I believe it was game three. Let me check. Yep, game three. He went 2 for 10, 0 for 4 from the 3-point line. He scored 7 points. That's not gonna cut it.
I had 7 points. That's 3 buckets. I can give you that.
And then Danny Green, he choked. All right, he choked against the Raptors, bro. I mean, against the 76ers. They needed a go ahead bucket for three. He was wide open, clank off the rim. That was to tie the game up, and he just couldn't do it. And that's disappointing. And he also, I believe that was in game two. And he also had a terrible game. 1 of 6 from the 3-point line. And he was just throwing it up. He was shooting and he was missing. Bro, he thought he was about to cash out there. Bro, Danny Green choked. He choked in game two. I expect nothing different in this game. Kawhi Leonard will have a great game. He will. But it just won't be enough. It won't be enough for Joel Embiid, Jimmy Butler, and Tobias Harris. It won't be enough, you know? Mike Scott and James Ennis, they've been swapping on who's having a good game off the bench. And if they can continue to get that 10 to 11 points off the bench, I feel like the 76ers will be fine, you know? Last game, Mike Scott had 11. James Ennis had, James Ennis had, I forgot. He had 5. James Ennis had 5. And then in game 3, James Ennis had, 10? And then Mike Scott had 5. So if they can keep doing that, then the 76ers would be fine. And they're going to win this game. And like I said, it's going to be a great game. It's going to be a close one. That one's going to be real close. I think it comes down to the wire. But ultimately, I have the 76ers winning. And they're going to the Eastern Conference Finals to play the Bucks. And as we wrap up this video, all I want to say is, I'm never wrong. No, I'm playing. But, you know, I can't wait to watch that game. I'm going to be tuned in. And make sure you're tuned in to the game, because it's going to be a great game. And that's the end of this video. Just make sure you smash that like button, comment, subscribe, and share it there right now. And I'll see you in there. So, peace.
When a nigga pull up on me, tell the nigga, baby, don't you know all of these niggas wish that they could bag that? I'm just saying, boy, you playing, you gon' let it wind down. You got 24 seconds and it starts.